It was 1916 when Idaho Power officially began, but our story begins 34 years earlier. In the little mountain town of Ketchum, Idaho, the Philadelphia Mining Company put up a water wheel generator on the Wood River. It produced the first kilowatt of electricity generated in the state of Idaho. The first small hydroelectric dam on the Snake River in Idaho also was built by a mining company.
Near Murphy, Idaho, at Swan Falls, power lines climb the canyon walls. They reach across the desert and up into the Owyhee Mountains to the Trade Dollar Mine. Nellie Hutchinson, daughter of the mine's superintendent, operates the power plant's governor, setting the turbines into motion, creating the electricity that travels to the mill some 30 miles distant. This magnificent event transforms the Snake River into the most important body of water in the state of Idaho.
As chaos escalated in Europe, folks discovered Idaho. They came to ranch, farm, open stores, log timber, and build railroads. Thousands of people in the territory were using electricity every day. And although it was safe to use, utility work was a dangerous profession. Linemen suffered serious injuries, and some even lost their lives. The electric companies were small, and there were so many of them, they teetered on the brink of solvency. In 1916, five realized they could survive by cooperating rather than competing for customers. On August 1st, they introduced to the world a single consolidated entity, the Idaho Power Company. The new company operated nine hydroelectric dams on the Snake River, including the first, Swan Falls. Generation capacity was 20,000 kilowatts. With 18,000 customers between Blackfoot, Idaho and Vail, Oregon, the Idaho Power Company was off to a good start. Homemakers became powerful allies in the company's effort to sell new, modern electric appliances, along with the power to run them. The era of the new all-electric home had begun.
Every woman knows the struggle to keep a house clean, to cook, do the washing and ironing for her family. We want these wonderful new electric servants in our homes.
Idaho Power's electric cooking schools and appliance demonstrations created new markets for household appliances. By the end of the decade, 35% of the company's customers had switched from coal and wood to electricity for cooking. The drought of 1919 devastated farmers and the economy of southern Idaho. $25 million in crop losses. To ensure sufficient water supplies for agriculture, new dams and canal irrigation systems were built. Water flowed in abundance from Milner Dam on the Snake River near Burley and Diversion Dam on the Boise River. New farms followed the water. Idaho Power salesmen followed the farmers. New transmission lines followed the salesmen. While potatoes, sugar beets, corn, and alfalfa turned the desert green, electrical appliances were filling the farmhouses.
Back in 1905, a fellow invented the electric toaster. We didn't sell any of those. None of my customers wanted toast. But that little contraption with its wires and its switches, nothing short of revolutionary. It inspired the appliances my customers want today. They want clothes washers, irons, refrigerators, ranges, water heaters, cream separators, and butter churns. Yes, sir. My best customers anymore are not farmers. It's their wives.
Rural electrification expands the modern convenience of electricity onto the plains and prairies. Idaho Power's rural service builds new power lines that reach out into the countryside. Their trucks deliver new work-saving, time-saving, and knuckle-saving electrical appliances to farmers and ranchers. and service representatives even make repairs. Rural electrification increases Idaho Power's customer numbers and demand for electricity. Convenience, efficiency, comfort, and even a bit of free time come to the rugged dawn-to-dusk life of the rancher and farmer.
You know, the stock tanks don't freeze up with those little heaters in them. We've got electric-powered chicken brooders, milking machine, yard lights outside the barn. Farming gets in your blood, you know. My dad used to say it's an existence one simply endures. But with the Idaho Power Company's help, the wife and I almost enjoy it now.
In just 8 years, Idaho Power establishes itself as the major electric utility in southern Idaho and eastern Oregon. Customers double to more than 40,000. The economy of the Snake River Valley thrives. Manufacturing, mining, food processing, and other industries prosper using electricity. These partnerships are critical to the company's growth.
Of course, Idaho Power couldn't sell more electricity without generating more. So the company continued to build through the 20s. Transmission lines, substations, rural extensions, hydroelectric generating plants, and the dams that supported them. The Swan Falls plant was expanded. Its electricity was being sold to the growing cities of Boise, Nampa, and Caldwell. The largest dam was at American Falls, also on the Snake River.
A dam at American Falls, built by the Bureau of Reclamation, is the answer to surviving future droughts, and a new power plant at that site will double Idaho Power Company's generating capacity. A half mile wide and 9 stories tall, the dam can hold back 25 miles of the Snake River. The reservoir will be the second largest in the U.S., storing an inexhaustible supply of water for farmers. But to build it, the entire town of American Falls is packed up and moved to higher ground. When finished in 1927, the dam's gates close, water begins to rise, and the old town site and wagon ruts from the old Oregon Trail vanish beneath 56,000 acres of Snake River water.
Yep. Things are rosy for the company. Rural electrification changed everything around here. 50,000 customers, 10,000 of them are high-value rural farm customers. More kilowatts of electricity, more miles of power lines, more customers than we ever imagined. And our engineers, they just keep planning bigger and better things.
On Monday, October 28, 1929, officers, employees, even customers thought the company was destined to continue this amazing growth. The next day, everything changed. October 29th, Black Tuesday. The New York Stock Exchange came crashing down.